My name is Molly Sidlecki, and I will be your host and MC this evening. Tonight, we have 122 ensembles from about 270 students working in groups of 1, 2, and 3. The students were given 3 weeks to respond to an invention or innovation to respond to our theme this year, inventions and innovations. Which, fun little fact, that was actually going to be our theme during the year 2020, which unfortunately was shut down. So tonight we have 3 esteemed judges to evaluate all of the projects you'll be seeing. They will be judging in 3 key areas: concept, creativity, and craft. This evening's judges are professor in the School of Art and Design, Amy Fichter. The director of the Dunn County Historical Society, Melissa Nealand. And owner of Barbara Lynn's Vintage, Mesa Mariah. Tonight, students will be competing for the following prize categories: first, second, and third, along with artistry and craft, accessories and style, innovative use of material, and avant-garde fashion. The grand prize this evening will be the $1,000 scholarship award. Every team has had the opportunity to apply and be considered for the scholarship award. The recipient is determined by the scholarship committee, made up of faculty from the School of Art and Design. So it's been 3 years since we've been on the runway. Last year we had a different setup. So it's super awesome to be back, and I'm super excited to see so many faces in the crowd tonight. Joining us for the first time with the runway is UW-Stout's very own Chancellor, Catherine Frank. And it's been rumored that she's been wanting to see this event since she began here at Stout. And one more thing. The School of Art and Design professor, Kate Maury, started this project approximately 22 years ago. And this will be Kate's last year of this event, as she is retiring at the end of this term. So again, let's give it up for Kate and all things fashion without fabric. Are you guys ready to see some fashion without fabric? Let's begin. Perry Messias and Owen Schilling, taking on Jet Engine. Sleek, quick, bold. Sophisticated, heroic, classy. All words synonymous with the iconic Jet Engine. Lifted into the heavens on a pair of wings, this marvel of innovation dominates the skies. In awe and wonder paralyzes the masses to the deadly truth. What lies behind the glistening facade is a trail of sooty contamination, poisoning our earth. As we begin taking off into the future, we must also wake up and start taking on the responsibility of preserving it. Radiance, solar panel. Solar panels were invented as a way to convert the sun into power. They are hardworking and useful machines. Well, here is a solar panel that does nothing. She just lies around soaking up the sun all day and not doing anything useful whatsoever. Kelsey Bleck, Hannah Sternagel. Deformed by defectivity. Fire alarm, smoke detector. Beep, beep, beep. That should be the noise you hear when the smoke detector goes off. However, this was not the case for Kelsey. Poor Kelsey. She stayed up so late working on her drawing homework that she forgot to replace the batteries. Now, instead of that fresh spring look, she's burnt to a crisp. But hey, this girl is lit. Engulfed in smoke and flames, Kelsey is the new girl on fire. Kat, Dirks, and Allison Flanham. Music of the 50s, the melodica. The melodica has been used by many artists, including John Lennon and the Beach Boys, since the 1950s and was used to give off a vintage feel and good vibrations. This instrument comes in many colors and is still popular in some genres of music today. Our piece emulates the design of a melodica as well as popular colors and dress style of the 50s, the year the melodica was made. Unlike the melodica made in the 1950s, ours was a pain in the neck to make. Xander Folkadal and Luke Slady Espinosa. The Buried, Roller Coasters. Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, come one, come all, for the chance to ride The Buried, a roller coaster you surely won't forget about. After this baby's been out of commission for years solely because of the unforgiving outside world and not because of any incidents whatsoever, it's back. And sure to give you the ride of a lifetime. Please don't mind the rust and overgrowth. That's always been there. Max Guido. The iron oven, blast furnace. What comes to mind when you think of blast furnace? Maybe a cool suit of armor? Yeah, we thought so too. Using the shapes of a blast furnace and an industrial metal motif, we created a suit of armor that really captures the feeling of being trapped in a swelteringly hot tube for 6 hours. So enjoy as the least practical, but definitely hottest knight you've ever seen makes an entrance. Matthias Van Horn. Spin cycle, washing machine. Oh, y'all wanted a twist? Well, how about a spin? Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the stage, the washing machine themed spin cycle. All the spinning and washing with none of the clothes to get in the way. With the focus on the function of the washing machine, spin cycle brings dynamic movement and a clean silhouette to the stage. The sound of nostalgia, cassette tapes and CDs, disco, diners, the Cold War, all of these events have one thing in common, the 80s. All but a fond memory, we've paid homage to the music lovers of this decade with our cassette and CD-inspired piece, a wonderful symphony of vintage, yes, vintage, icons of its time, mimicking the styles of the decade. Ari Pinder, Jasmine Sanchez. My electric heart, pacemaker. Invented in 1958, the pacemaker is essential to keeping hearts with arrhythmias on beat. Just like how the pacemaker sends electric currents to the heart, this design will shock you in ways you've never seen before. My electric heart is a fusion of technology and anatomy that will steal your heart, or keep it pumping. We're not picky. Nikki Peterson, Tegan Shedler. Rouge de la Danse Nuit, fire, controlled fire. The 19th century brought about a lot of things, and the Gothic Revival was one of them. A conscious design was made by everyone to relive this era. With an abundant use of black metal and red lights, beautiful lanterns flood the night sky. Bell, Libby Stritmatter. Scissors, scissors. Caution, cut hazard. Product has functional sharp edges. Contact may result in injury. Always keep blades away from fingers and body. Abigail Maddle, Taylor Van Dyke. Blasting off, rocket propulsion. The concept of rocket propulsion was brought to a bright flame by a physicist named Dr. Robert Hutchings Goddard. We use this to embody a physical costume with the topics of flames and flight. Hansen, Julian Cladwell Coyle, Caroline Pink. Lost in the Web, the Internet. Our project, Lost in the Web, is inspired by AI. What a better way to display internet than asking AI itself? Here we present an inspired AI-generated look of what the internet would appear as a person. Bella Hughes, Janie Kemper. The Forging of the Iron Queen, Blacksmithing and Metalsmithing. Blacksmithing and metalsmithing have been used as early as 100 AD by using fire to melt metal. Both have been staples for hundreds of years to create tools and armor like chainmail. Novi Touchstone. CRISPR gene editing. CRISPR. Behold, CRISPR gene editing, a mighty warrior of myth found in the 1980s with the power to manipulate the very DNA of life, forging a new path in medicine, agriculture, and beyond. Let us honor and celebrate this hero and continue to wield its power with wisdom and grace. Elena Hodge. Nina, the Plasma Cutter Fighter. Plasma cutting is a process that cuts through electrically conductive materials. It's hot, throws sparks, and it's crazy. The plasma torch can cut through steel, stainless steel, aluminum, brass, and copper, all while making sparks fly. Scott, the protector, contraceptives, and birth control. The protector defends others and themselves from the unplanned things in life. Our main objective is to provide safe birth control options for all. Birth control is the practice of preventing unwanted pregnancies, and the protector will help safeguard your future. We are fully equipped with contraceptives and latex condoms, IUDs, birth control packets, sponges, and even long-term solutions like vasectomies and tubal ligation procedures. Molly McDowell and Bryce Rupnow, more power to you, fiber optic cables. The invention of the fiber optic wire allows 65,000 times more data to be transmitted than was previously possible. This has led to the creation of fiber optic cables. Fiber optic cables transmit light through cables made of glass or plastic. The light inside the cable travels by reflection. The core of the cable is reflective and the casing is not. This causes the light to bounce rapidly from core to casing. The reflection between core and casing is mimicked through the design's structured shawl and reflective midriff area. The rapidly reflected light can transmit voice, sound, images, and other data at nearly the speed of light. Forrest Norden, Taylor Schumacher, Consequences, Gregorian Calendar. Everyone wants to be remembered in history, make a dent in the fleeting life of humanity. Unfortunately, that desire can cause irreparable damage to the universe as we know it. The invention of the Gregorian calendar, a replacement for the widely used Julian calendar, sparked a particular scientist to delve deeper into the intricacies of time, both past and present. His invention proved failure and soon corrupted his body, making him become the monster we see phasing through timelines to this day. He has learned, is learning, and will learn that his actions have horrible consequences. Jasmine Gross, the SS-45 Zeppelin. I am the 1937 steampunk Victorian princess. I am a sassy and arrogant, a do-what-I-kind kind of girl. I decided to steal my father's Zeppelin airship, the SS-45 Zepp. It was a pitch black night, but I wanted to be a pilot, so I took it out anyway. Did I know how to fly? Definitely not, but I didn't care. And just like the Hindenburg, the Zeppelin caught on fire, crashed, and burned. But it's okay, I made it. That's the only important thing. But in the end, my father will never let me near a Zeppelin again. Peyton Cunningham, Aaron McKinley, Lauren Tolbert. Tupperware. Tupperware was first invented in the 1942 during World War II for American soldiers to hold meals, toilet paper, and cigarettes when stationed on the war front. Back at home, duties of housewives included running their houses efficiently by investing in war bonds, planting victory gardens, and rationing. Patriotic propaganda was spread all over the U.S., encouraging homemakers to participate in civil defense activities. Kaylin Behrens, Natalie Falk. The Stealth Nighthawk, Stealth Bomber. Here's one invention that's probably not on your radar. One that delivers ammunition and nuclear munitions at 623 miles per hour. One made with angular radar absorbent panels and is virtually undetectable. One begs the question, how many targets can be taken out by a single aircraft? The F-117 stealth bomber was invented and designed by Lockheed Martin in 1981. With 21 models created since its inception, it is one of the most highly renovated aircrafts to date. Using a series of sleek, geometric shapes, our stealth Nighthawk launches the F-117 off a new type of runway, reinventing it once again. Marissa Jensen, Peyton Knox, Jay Ryder. To the bone, internal, external fixation. In 1900, medical procedures were dangerous and many people feared injuries associated with procedures involving broken bones. With the lack of proper medicine, many people were left untreated, worsening their quality of life. This was until Albin Lamont, the pioneer of osteosynthesis, discovered internal-external fixation. Screws were placed inside and outside the bone to stabilize and set the fractured area. This was a medical breakthrough in orthopedic surgery that changed the lives of people forever. Michael Martin, Emily Nelson, Glacius et Ignis, refrigeration. Ice and fire, hot and cold, thought to be forever diametrically opposed. This automation symbolizes the unification of these opposites to create a system some may think is impossible. Known to the world as Glacius et Ignis, she contains elements of cooling and heating, using advanced compression and expansion techniques to keep the people's goods nice and fresh. Her creation marks the dawn of a new era of refrigeration technology. Make sure to close the fridge door when not in use. Robinson Illig, Bella LeClaire, Donovan Stoddard. Play-Doh Punk, Play-Doh. You know her, you love her, and you've probably tried to eat her. Give it up to Play-Doh! Before she was known as Play-Doh, they were a humble wall cleaner back in the 1950s. When her wallpaper company started to go out of business, she was introduced to children as a fun little creative activity in the classroom by her sister and aunt of Joseph McVicker, the owner of the Kudal Cleaner Company. With a bit of style change, she rocks the world with vibrant colors and endless possibilities. This freeform toy has no limits and breaks the rules, and she shows it. Kaylee Sevick, Queen of Hearts, cartoon and animation. In her hand, the Queen of Hearts holds a zoetrope, a Victorian animation device from the 19th century that was one of the first variations of animation technology. As she spins the barrel, the hearts spring to life. Inspired by the story of Alice in Wonderland, Her Highness's ensemble is meant to mirror the late 19th century Victorian style. The pop of color elevates the idea of her clownish character and presents a stylized cartoon variation of the royal girl boss you have never seen before. Amanda Billerbeck, Mallory Jukabut, Ella Torkelson. Latex metamorphosis, rubber. Made from white tree tears with many presses and gears, out of this rubber born, to be used and formed and worn. Yellow ducks and toy trucks, the soles of our chucks, and thin stretchy sleeves to protect your hands from disease. Rubber is one of mankind's most versatile creations. Latex, silicone, and foam are the most common forms and can be found in every corner of our daily lives. After being tapped, the white sap of a rubber tree is cured and ready to be molded into a limitless expanse of different objects and uses. Maria Burns, Kylie Huang, Kara Rasmussen, timekeeper, clocks. From sundials used by the Egyptians to sailors who measured time with an hourglass out at sea, humans have long been obsessed with keeping track of time. Our lives quite literally revolve around clocks. We wake up to alarms and punch in and out of work of our time for work. Without clocks, our structured life would be no more. Mechanical clocks were first invented by Christian monks and soon evolved into pocket watches and grandfather clocks. Clocks have been advancing for hundreds of years, and they still are today. Innovation. Why might you ask? Well, it's quite simple, alcohol. This metabolic process is the reason why your favorite bar exists. Raise a glass to Louis Couture, who first discovered fermentation in 1857. Times were good until the 18th Amendment was enacted in 1919, prohibiting the production, transportation, and sale of alcoholic beverages. This created an era of rebellion with the onset of bootleggers and homebrewing. Whiskey barrels and flappers filled the hidden walls of speakeasies in the 1920s era of women's rights and organized crime, defined a period that stands iconic today. Kara Kaufman, Orion Oat Gutenberger, and Jacob Cow. Pop, lock, and rock. Pop rocks. William A. Mitchell, an American food critic, put together sugar, carbon dioxide, and applied 600 pounds of pressure to create a pop-in instant soda mix. However, the resulting chemical reaction created these raging rock stars. Our crystalline pop rockers are an innovative take on the nostalgic, popular 80s candy and pop rock music genre. Our creation demonstrates the two sides, pop and rock. One liberally focuses on rigid structures, while the other emphasizes explosive dynamics. Both work in harmony to bounce off of each other in an appetizing visual experience. Of their DNA is the same. DNA fingerprinting is a method used to analyze the differences between the remaining 0.1%. It is often used for solving crimes and paternity testing. Samples of DNA can be taken from skin cells, hair, or blood. This concept displays the process of turning DNA from blood into comprehensible data, while also reinforcing the character of Miss Scarlet in Clue, a murder mystery film that was released only 1 year after the invention of DNA fingerprinting. Budding's garden, lawnmower. Invented in 1830 by Edwin Budding, the lawnmower was originally made to maintain extravagant gardens in the backyards of mansions and palaces. The smell of fresh-cut grass swarms the air, trimmed hedges towering over you as you take a stroll through the maze, a hat over your head to keep the bright glow of the sun from your eyes. Your frilly skirt moves along with the wind, as the scent of nearby roses and tulips surround you. Spring is here, and nature has awoken. Thank you. J. Curl, Xander McFall. Dr. Something, microscopic surgery. A doctor with a caffeine addiction that went beyond too far. The very coffee filters used building up their billowy, extravagant attire. This medic made leaps and bounds in the scientific research field by operating on themselves. So much to the point that their very spine is extruding from their being. At this point, their function is fueled solely by their endless cup of joe. They have fused a metallic magnifying glass to their now never-resting arm to inspect the gushing gash on their stomach. How sane, caffeine, the backbone of their inquiry, is making me feel groggy. Bubblegum Kish, bubblegum. Bubblegum, bubblegum in a dish, how many pieces do you wish? The sticky, chewy candy we can't get enough of is on display here tonight. Envisioned as the uniform at a fictional candy factory's gum division, this confectionery creation invokes the playful, whimsical spirit we typically associate with the treat. Life isn't all gumdrops and rainbows at the gum factory, though. Our model has just finished her 9-to-5 and is not taking any more baloney. Butter. People all around the world know the iconic taste of one of our favorite childhood foods, peanut butter. Its origins can be traced all the way back to the Incas, who ground down roast peanuts into a paste. It didn't evolve into its modern form until Dr. Kellogg patented the process from raw peanut to jar in 1895. Over 229 million Americans eat around 7 million pounds of the creamy concoction per year. Our ensemble is inspired by Kellogg's use of funnels and grinders to manufacture the paste and also merged with parts of the peanut plant. Douglas Ramlow, Ethan Short, Archangel, Aqueducts. Archangel is one of Neptune's forgotten children. This demigod gave the Romans the idea to use gravity and strong bridges to transport about 265 gallons of water per person per day. The design was so effective, the Roman capital alone constructed 11 aqueduct systems supplying fresh water via the towering stone bridges, constructed with arches from sources as far as 57 miles away. Archangel became rich as a result of royalties and has since become a fashion designer, making the dress you are allowed to witness today. Gracie Gutting, Braden Lang, Ella Sandin. Mr. Bright, Light Bright. Ladies and gentlemen, get ready for a blast from the past with Mr. Bright. Inspired by the classic toy invented in the 1967, our model is lighting up the runway with its dazzling design. This luminous design is meant to bring you back with bright, dazzling colors, abstract shapes, and lots of that original 70s vibe. The Light Bright was invented to build fine motor skills for children with autism and to enhance creativity for kids all around the world. You may recall the Light Bright motto, Light Bright, making things with light. What a sight, making things with Light Bright. Jace Johnson, John Shaver, Olivia Coyle, the Universal Product Code, UPC. The Universal Product Code, invented in 1948, is a barred matrix paired with a 12-digit number attached to the product. It is a personification of order, ensuring that the efficiency of modern commerce by labeling, organizing, and tracking every product. Implemented in 1947, the barcode enabled the automation and efficiency of retail, evidenced by the over 5 billion codes scanned every day. Our piece draws inspiration from the peplum dresses of the 1940s and 50s, while incorporating the eccentric contemporary business fashion of drag queen Willow Pill. The color palette, a drab black and white, represents the commanding nature of the barcode, while the red accents hints at the other half, the skinner. Here is Universal Product Code. Callie Kramer, Gwendolyn Rosso. Respect the dip, drip, spray paint. Spray paint has become synonymous as the iconic medium used in street art. It is a truly versatile medium that can be used to replicate almost anything with its own stylistic element. Designed as a way to speed up painting textured surface, it has transcended these humble beginnings to becoming an incredibly recognized art form that knows no barriers, from its use for identification, maintenance, or safety, and its ease of use contributes to its involvement in rebels, gangs, and artistic movements throughout recent history. Joel Adifrid, Renee Smith. Hooked, fishing rod. Like a consumer in grocery stores, constantly lured by hanging baits, she was tempted to first sniff the treats. Enticed by the tasty-looking lures, unaware of the consequences, she fell into the trap. A fish hook planted deep in her skull, a fish spear right through her guts, all thanks to a clever innovation, which seems to emerge in any settlement. To find an easier way to defeat hunger, fishing from the shore never made easier. Jordan Contreras, Gracie Spindler, Celine Nelson. The clones of 6LL3, cloning. Far in the future, the royal clones of planet 6LL3 celebrate their origins. Please remain calm in the presence of Her Majesty as her cloned royal guards are ready to jump at the opportunity to get some target practice in. Her protection is warranted by the presence of Her Majesty Dolly, named after the first cloned mammal from an adult somatic cell and crowned in lamb horns and wool. She carries the future generations of cloned royalty upon her scepter, ensuring her everlasting rule over the cloned people. Caleb Collins, Dustin Gray. 1847 Sweet Tooth, Donut. Thanks to 16-year-old Hanson Gregory, we have today's famous sweet breakfast food. In the 1800s, donuts made of fried dough would take many different shapes. However, the modern donut shape came about in 1847 because Hanson was sick of having raw dough in the center and decided to cut it out. The name donut was created because they would fill the hole in the center with various nuts. Since then, this has become the standard shape and they are now mass-produced in factories. We took the idea of mass production and combined it with the 1840s fashion and created the 1847 Sweet Tooth. Logan Mentes, In Focus, Optical Lens. The optical lens is a simple but powerful device that has revolutionized the way we see the world. Used in eyeglasses, telescopes, cameras, and microscopes, virtually anything with the ability to magnify. When working in tandem with light transmission, the optical lens enables us to see things that were once invisible to the naked eye. The reflective color incorporated into our jacket depicts the range of visible light that the lens manipulates. We experimented with the idea of clarity throughout our design, just as the optical lens allows us to focus in on the world around us. Flatterty, Jenny Harding, Pirate Queen, Boat. With our invention being boat, we decided to create a fashionable outfit that would be one perfect fit for Her Majesty, the Pirate Queen. This outfit is a throwback to the golden age of piracy, with grand sails that would float anyone's boat and pearls that are fit for anyone's booty. This outfit is walk the plank ready. Samantha Kewell, Sam Kishler, Celia Powell. Sweet tooth, gummy bear. What do you call a bear without any teeth? A gummy bear. Now, I'm sorry if you hate puns, but this script is barely over. Honestly, what a weird innovation to get for this project, but we managed to barely salvage what we could and turn it into a clawtastic outfit, rightly named Sweet Tooth. An assortment of sweets, candies, and childhood tokens adorn the outfit. There's no sugarcoating it. It's pretty sweet. You might be asking, are these puns ever going to get punny? Probably not. Courtney Burr, Ashley Dorr. Swiss Army Knight. Tools. We aren't tooling with you. This is a conglomeration of the past 2.5 million years' worth of human tool development in one object. Introducing the Swiss Army Knight. Referencing traditional Swiss attire, this dress is sure to unfurl in front of your eyes. Designed during World War I, containing any tool known to mankind, including the knife, corkscrew, file, and much, much more. Honestly, what else could you ask for? J.J. Emmons, Sarah Steubenberg. Tied and true. Rope. Excuse me, this is not a drill. This is the real deal. Sarah Steubenberg and J.J. Emmons are bringing you the newest in rope royalty with their runway look, Tied and True. For those of you curious about whether or not this look uses real pre-made rope, I'm afraid not. This outfit is 100% hand-twisted out of recycled materials. This look was influenced by the Western purpose of rope, so don't get it twisted, and enjoy Sarah and JJ's Tied and True. Sarah Brubecker, Jamie Carls, Maddie Stroop. Transformer, wheel and axle. Wheels and axles inspired the invention of the car. Cars inspired Transformers, including Optimus Prime. This hefty unit is complete with heated seats, a sunroof, a backup camera, and an amazing navigation system. This 4-liter twin-turbo V8 engine is perfect for running your day-to-day errands, such as grocery shopping, picking up your children, or plowing through crowds of people when in a hurry. Behold, Optimus Prime. Casey, Alex Rowley, Stones and Bones, Chalkboard. Welcome students, class is in session. Meet Professor Chalkboard. This guy was born in the 1800s. He may be dusty, but he's brought practical use to the classroom for centuries. Originally made with smooth, dark slate, learning without this classic contraption would be dull as a rock. But the boards are only half the story. Chalk's origins began with dead sea animals and shells being fossilized and turned into limestone. The limestone is ground up and compacted to form the solidified tower you find in every old classroom. Cedar Gomer, James Jager. Diesel Spartan, diesel engine. Top 5 innovations. Number 5, the diesel engine. Number 4, the diesel engine. Number 3, the diesel engine. Number 2, the diesel engine. Lastly, number 1, the diesel engine. The diesel engine deserves all spots in the top 5 because it is simply the apex of all things. You would not have anything if the diesel engine wasn't around. Aaron Hoyt, Nate Johnson, transmutator, hybridization. Hybridization is the process of combining two different organisms to create a new and unique one. It is the ultimate genetic mixer party, where the genes of two species come together to create a hybrid that has characteristics of both parents. Now, you might be thinking, why would anyone want to do that? Well, the answer is simple. Hybridization can create some truly remarkable and hilarious plants and creatures. So, next time you're feeling bored with the same old animals and plants, remember that there's a whole world of hybridization out there waiting to be explored. Who knows what crazy combinations you might discover? Belle Davis, Devin Take, Emery Wolfsteller, Wings of Flight, Kite. Kites are super cool, and everyone likes kites. You may be wondering what this beautiful outfit is. Well, let me tell you. This is Da Vinci's flying machine that can't actually fly. Synthesizer. Beep, boop, bop. Jaden Larson, shiny as metal, aluminum. Put your shades on, because this shiny dress will sure blind your eyes. Number 13 on periodic table, aluminum is known for its silver color and being a lightweight metal. It wasn't until 1985 that cans were used for beverages. They were used because aluminum is easily molded. There are nearly 180 billion cans made every year of aluminum. The great thing about aluminum is that it can be melted down and turned into something new. Melissa Jones, Aaron Polam, the fire escape. Somebody call 911, shoddy fire burning on the dance floor. Dang, that's fire. My boy looking hot. Who needs a fire hose when this baller is dropped up on the wazoo? What's that? You want to see the next outfit? Give me a hot minute, all right? I've got time to burn. Damn, son, those wings are fly. Sheesh! Y'all better like this monologue, because I'm spitting flames. No kizzy. Jalissa Vandenhoevel. Wood foundation, plywood. Plywood has been invented since ancient Egypt, having different variations until 1835, where a British inventor named Samuel Bentham formed the first modern plywood. He took thin sheets of wood glued together, creating a strong base for housing. It was presented through history, having a notable debut in World War II, a popular material for aircraft and boats. In fact, one time they tried to create a full-on plane out of plywood. That ended horribly. After the war, it became popular for constructing, furniture, packaging, even musical instruments. Its strength and durability helping it be one of the most popular building materials in the world. Now we hope we can be popular with another field, fashion. Jenna Good, Tyler Peterson. Turning of the seasons, windmill. Prepare to be blown away. Originating in the Netherlands, the imagery of Dutch windmills and rows of multicolored tulips are interlinked. In this design, we painted with all the colors of the wind and reimagined those rows of tulips by building a cape out of over 200 pinwheels. In the modern day, windmills are more commonly used for decoration, while wind turbines are used to generate power, being the second largest source of renewable energy on the planet. Stop and smell the tulips as we present the turning of the seasons. Edwin Dubrow, Samantha Stalzer. Light of the night, fireworks. Terrifying pets and children since the 2nd century BCE, fireworks remain one of the most aesthetically beautiful ways to injure or even kill oneself and others. According to historians, the earliest version of fireworks appeared in China during the Han Dynasty, when bamboo stems were thrown into a fire to cause a loud explosion. Since then, fireworks have been used to light up a variety of events, including New Year celebrations, wildfire starting gender reveal parties, and the family barbecue, when someone with too many beers in them wants to see something blow up. Nathan Johnson, Lee LaPiana, buried alive, shovel. Can you dig it? Because with a shovel, you certainly can. This iconic tool can be dated back as early as the Neolithic age, when they came in the form of animal shoulders. Since then, shovels have continued to aid man in our pursuit to reshape the earth to our liking. The inspiration for this piece was archaeology. Archaeologists often use shovels to reveal artifacts, fossils, and other ancient treasures, many of which can be seen within this design. There's also plenty of elements from the natural world incorporated here. Yep, this outfit is truly the whole package. Alyssa Kohler, Zeke Wagner. The rise of the mariachi, a chilling celebration. Guitar. Ladies and gentlemen, brace yourselves for the most bone-tingling fashion moment of the night. Feast your eyes on our avant-garde ensemble, the Skeletal Serenader. A dapper skeleton mariachi, complete with a wide brim sombrero, perched on his bony head, strumming a guitar with gusto. Our mariachi is all bones and no flesh, giving a whole new meaning to dress to the bones. Check out that poncho with its vibrant hues and intricate designs. It's the perfect blend of style and skeletal sass. It's a fashion statement that's sure to make heads turn and jaws drop, and you won't be able to resist tapping your feet to the ghostly melodies of this skeletal sensation. Olé! Aiden Helwig, Aaron Imbedin. The heart of electronics, microchips. Microchips are like the beating heart of every electronic device on the planet. In 1958, when it was invented, no one knew how much it would revolutionize modern technology. Electronic devices went from an entire room of machinery to something that fits in the palm of your hand in only a few decades. The look of the trench coat is inspired by 1950s fashion, but underneath is a more modern design. This 50s style creation was stolen straight from Bill Gates' closet. Lexi Stein, Leah Whittle. The Greatest Show, Tent. Joshua Purdy was the first to use a tent for his circus in 1825. Today in 2023, this group is using the circus tent as the inspiration for their creation. The circus is known to draw attention from the crowds and add in hidden, unexpected details. Unfortunately, you won't be seeing any trapeze from this model, but you'll be seeing this group's beautifully created dress with an unexpected surprise. Alex Colmenares, Nan Fowler. Unshackled, padlock, and combination lock. Made to protect yourself, your money, your social security, your mother's maiden name, and those worn-out Polaroids of your ex. From the land of olives and philosophy, we bring you the padlock. Let's take you back to the Colosseum with our Roman-inspired design, entitled Unshackled. Featuring silver foam shackles, chains, and a colorful reveal at the end. Take it away, soldier. Matthew Vandermeer, Paige Zimmerman. Refracting reality, virtual reality. First designed in the 1980s, virtual reality is a simulation that can allow you to drive cars and climb environments through computer imaging showing 3D graphics. Virtual reality is mainly used for video games, but can also be applied to real-life situations. Virtual reality can also include controllers that allow how you feel objects to create your immersion in the simulated world. Combining 80s aesthetics and a computer environment, we showcase virtual reality by transferring pixels to natural stones and rocks. Our design focuses on a retro experience and nostalgic time period that combines the past and future. Holly Berg, Hannah Hagman, Lily Shield, On the Street, Bicycle. The invention of the bicycle has revolutionized the way people move and has had a significant impact on art and society. Its versatility, affordability, and sustainability have made it a popular choice for urban and rural transportation. In New York City alone, there are 1.9 million cyclists. Influencing street style and street art, the bicycle has become an integral part of our culture. When planning our design, we highlighted elements of a bike. For example, the strength of the chain and the radial beauty of the wheel. We also tie in the bright colors and sleek style of streetwear, two things that emphasize the place many bikes call home. Paige Atherton, Emma McGraw, Constructive Criticism, Crane. When you think of a crane, do you think of the word sympathetic? Comforting? No, you think of the intimidating, looming nature of the arm and the geometric rigid structure which inspires us to use mainly cardboard and metal. Since they were made in the Greco-Roman era, cranes have only become more cold and unfeeling, while simultaneously being more helpful. Constructive criticism captures the contemporary menacing tone of a crane by taking inspiration from tall emo women and construction workers. Vanessa Freeberg, Sabrina Hagberg, Stole My Heart, Organ Transplant. In less than 100 years, organ donation has saved over 1 million lives in the U.S. In 1954, history was made when the first successful organ transplant was performed with a kidney. The liver, heart, and pancreas followed suit in the 1960s, along with the lungs and intestinal organs in the 1980s. Our project utilizes the key parts of organ transplant: medical sheeting, a transplant box, surgical tools, and organs. Organ transplant is life-saving medicine, bringing to life thousands of patients a year. Lauren Lund, Sean Putzer, first responder, 911. The first call to 911 was in 1968. 911 is a call line for medical, fire, or life-threatening emergencies. It's also used to report crimes in progress. Our project focuses on the first responders that are brave enough to go out into the field and save lives. The style of our project is built on streetwear fashion and heavily uses the color orange because of its high visibility and for its role in emergency service apparel and equipment. Eva Grom, Kaylee Hemzish, Priority Mail, Mailbox. In 1913, something went boom. The letter bombing campaign started with an explosion. The invention of the mail has a complicated history, and it is inextricably linked to the struggle of the suffragettes. Bombs were used as letters to destroy property and to bring attention to their cause. Paying homage to the suffragettes, our corset features notable headlines. Our sleeves and hat reference modern packaging materials that we rely on today. We take freedom mailboxes give us for granted, but we can't forget the progress that has been made before us. Remember to always check your letters before opening them. River Olson, El Oval, a spark of enterprise, internal combustion engine. Originally invented during the Industrial Revolution, the internal combustion engine allowed for the development of several new kinds of transportation, including the automobile. Using the power of gasoline, sparks, and air compression, it allowed cars and the like to power themselves easily, changing transportation forever. In Spark of Enterprise, we have created a piece that resembles the engine in both form and function, particularly through the geometric frame resembling the pistons, which are the heart of the engine. Our dress combines older ideals in both fashion and industrialization to create a truly new design. controller, has Toller Spread. Press my buttons, remote control. Blaster, bleeper, clicker, clonker, flicker, gadget, gizmo, switcher, zapper. The remote goes by many names and has many functions and variations over the years. From the Zenith Space Command, or the clicker, to the common universal remotes we see today. Pulling influence from the iconic 80s fashion of shoulder pads, 80s and 90s remote designs, we focused on creating a sleek outfit that emphasized the traditional shape of the remote. Exploring the beauty of the inner workings and circuitry of the remote control, we figured out how you can press my buttons. Casey Karen, Quinn Graba, Hunter West. KN03, Gunpowder. Gunpowder is the first explosive. It was developed in the 9th century. One of the four great inventions of China, gunpowder was popularly used until the latter half of the 19th century. Gunpowder is used in many different inventions, such as fireworks and explosives. This piece is a contemporary take on gunpowder, with flowing pieces and different shades of black and gray. The ruffles on the piece symbolizes the explosive elements, along with the delicacy of raw gunpowder. Cordell Moe, Aiden Nord, Eli Morgan. The Whizzler, Cheese Whiz. Invented in 1951 as a replacement for Welsh rarebit in the British market, Cheese Whiz is a cheese product with an open secret. Unlike its original iteration, the version sold in America's stores today is not real cheese. One of the original creators, Dean Southworth, was noted in 2001 for purchasing a jar only to exclaim after eating it, "Holy God, it tastes like axle grease." Derived from its deceptive nature, our design embodies Cheese Whiz in the form of a cartoonishly evil villain, reminiscent of DC Comics' The Riddler. Meet the Whizzler. Karina Duggle, Madison Alsey. Dispensing joy. Soap. A slippery mess in the shower, a bubbly time in the bath, something you choose to cleanse after a long day. Scrub your chest in the rest. After that, you will feel the best. Several shapes or sizes, all melted in your hand, squeaky clean from head to toe, and it will make you glow. So you will be ready for the big show. Say nope to dropping the soap. Medi Look, Abbey School, Bridge Between, X-Ray. Have you ever broken a bone? If you have, you've probably gotten an X-ray for it. X-rays are a type of radiation called electromagnetic waves. It comes in many different forms, all used for different parts of the body. This piece simulates what it looks like to be inside a full body X-ray machine. This is shown through the radiation covers as a top, moving through the machine and ending at the skeletal legs, bridging the gap from the inside and the outside. Oliver Van Alman, 241 Bricks, Brick. 7,000 years ago, bricks were formed from clay and straw. And to this day, they remain one of the most popular building materials around. From fireplaces to facades, and of course chimneys, these little blocks of clay are truly an amazing innovation. Speaking of chimneys, King Henry VIII was so wealthy that he gifted an impressive 241 of them to Bishop Thomas Wolsey. Each one is said to be uniquely designed, and the intricate designs amaze us today. Talk about a generous gift. Reed Barbane, Kyla Jordan. Retrovision, television. At its inception, the television was nothing more than a small box with moving black and white images. But the arrival of MTV in the 80s sparked a new wave of social creativity. With dynamic styles and vibrant colors, MTV introduced a new world of artistic expression that captivated its viewers and renewed the culture of the past. Television became a gateway to a dimension with endless possibilities and imagination that continue to influence the culture we live in today. Retrovision. Kale Sparks, Reed Westfall, Circuit Centurion, Semiconductor. Semiconductors are used to regulate the flow of electricity from one conductor to another. The Circuit Centurion wears green and white armor in distinct patterning, reminiscent of the classic circuit board found in many electronics. But this look isn't just for show. The semiconductor technology built into his suit allows him to control his electric personality and channel his unyielding rage into destroying enemies in the gladiatorial pit. Kennedy Hanfield, Taylor Kevill, Adam Metz, The Extinguisher, Fire Truck and Fire Station. In 1736, the first American fire department was created in Philadelphia to spot fires and protect citizens. Today, we introduce the Extinguisher, the man who will save your children and seduce your wives. I mean, what's not to like? He saves cats from trees, extinguishes fires, and risks his life to save others. The Extinguisher is ready for action anytime, anywhere, with his beautiful portable fire hydrant and his hook and ladder streetwear. This baggy outfit illustrates the colorful arrays of reds and yellows with a splash of blue, allowing the Extinguisher to be spotted from miles away, ready to save the day. Addie Schmidt, Nicholas Wurz, Cherry Red, Kool-Aid. Kool-Aid has been around for decades, crashing through walls with its unmistakable presence to give us all a smile. The infamous bright red drink is a staple in nearly everyone's childhood. This piece plays on the nostalgia of being a kid, coming inside after a long day of playing out in the summer heat to enjoy a glass of refreshing Kool-Aid. Even adults can enjoy Kool-Aid, making this colorful drink a staple in wild nights out. We have created a bright and vibrant design that captures the essence of Kool-Aid in its iconic red color. Bornholz, Leah Connolly, CJ Job, Slide of Color, Microscope. Many have come face to face with a microscope. Whether you use it in a dreaded science unit in high school, it's a tool of your trade, or you just really like microscopes. The meaning of microscope is often synonymous with looking closer at things. In our design, we did just that. Its bright and energetic colors used throughout the garments make it seem as if you are looking into a microscope at a slide of pure color, examining the organism that resides within. Mason Meister, Ava Vanderbloemen, Through the Lens, Telescope. The telescope was invented in 1608 by Hans Liberty. The first telescopes were rudimentary and clunky, allowing only sight within our immediate solar system. Since the 17th century, the magnification and power of telescopes have grown immensely to allow us to explore the depths of the known universe. In our dress, Through the Lens, we wanted to explore a design of cosmic beauty. Our elegant dress features a long, flowy design decorated with galactic colors and a starry headband that complements our space theme. Emily Clarkson, Emily Sorum, Andrea Smith, Goddess of Abacus, Computer and PC. The first computer was invented in 1856 by the British mathematician Charles Babbage. Interestingly, the roots of the computer can be traced back to ancient civilizations and the invention of the abacus. NASA was at the forefront of the computing revolution, and many women were hired by NASA as prominent computers. However, many of their ideas and intelligence were discredited. To honor these women, we designed an elegant geometric dress made of salvaged computer components. We introduce to you the Goddess of Abacus. Abigail Van Elsen, Garrett Reese, The Devil's Rope, Barbed Wire. As homesteaders forced their way westward, they brought with them an innovation in property-securing technology, barbed wire. They strung it around what they claimed as their new land to enforce their boundaries with no regard for the blood they were shedding. Both cattlemen and Native Americans were stuck with the new burdens imposed by the spine-spun wire. Animals imprisoned in the wire received horrendous wounds and infections, which earned barbed wire the nickname Devil's Rope. Here, the devil proudly wears his rope as a mantle of destruction and entrapment for all to fear. Dane Talbot settled, the revolution of energy, nuclear fusion. In 50 years, our planet will be depleted of all fossil fuels and carbon will plague our atmosphere. Some turn to nuclear fission, a science all nuclear power plants uses that leads to nuclear meltdowns and toxic waste. Luckily, there's an energy revolution people call our last chance. Nuclear fusion is a process that, by smashing two atoms together, generates power up to 1 million times that of fossil fuels and 4 times that of fission. Fusion is the same way stars generate heat. It produces no carbon or nuclear waste, and it glows a magnificent purple-pink hue during a nuclear reaction. Quincy Aaron, Sophie Marlowe, Tresselia, the Gaslighter, Gaslight. Bonsoir, it's me, Lady Lucille, otherwise known as the Gaslighter. People may perceive me as a cold-hearted strumpet, but my heart is burning with passion. How did I come to be, you may ask? Well, my darling dear, I am a showgirl at heart. I learned that in order to shine like a star, I had to strut my stuff. I'm sure you've seen me before. No, don't you dare be gaslighting me. My 1800s flair is gonna light up your world, honey. Brie Grinley, Will Mace, Bad Blood, Insulin. Insulin was created in the 1920s. This innovation has helped the lives of millions of people who suffer from diabetes. Insulin is naturally produced by the pancreas. However, some people's bodies do not produce enough for their bodies to survive. Shots of insulin can be given through a syringe or an insulin pump. Inspired by the flapper girls of the 1920s, this dress makes use of the crucial syringe and pump as major design elements. Jack Carson, Thomas Newman. The Fastenite, metal fastenings. The screw, the nail, the bolt, and the rivet. Metal fastenings have been used throughout history as pivotal elements of nearly every subsequent invention. First invented in the early medieval period, metal fastenings were famously used in the construction of plated armor. Born from the forges of old, the Fastenite utilizes elements from a multitude of different fasteners. With bolted joints and a corkscrew heart, he spirals forth on his quest to bring the world together. Dex Burnett, Anne-Marie Morrison, Abby Borash, the champion of Legoland, Lego. The invention of Lego brought innovation to kids' minds, teaching them new levels of creativity and giving them a way to bring their creations to life using only simple tricks. The idea expanded from wooden toys, slowly evolving into a favorite childhood toy for decades to come. With new movies and TV shows, as the years went on, Lego paired up with amazing heroes and brave fighters. But even Legoland itself calls for a protector. We bring you the one, the only, champion of Legoland. Kayana Erickson, Ellie Koska, Alyssa Kupal. A splash from the past, Super Soaker. The Super Soaker, invented in 1989 by Lonnie Johnson, changed the way kids had fun in the sun. Utilizing that adrenaline rush from having our own water wars as kids, the striking neon colors and water features will leave you frozen in shock. The rebellious fashion of the late 80s takes on a punk spin in this powerful look that does the original commercials justice. To sum up this invention, in the words of the 2004 Super Soaker, wetter is better. Aubrey Brunner, Devin Francine. Harnessing electromagnetic wave, radar. Radio detection and ranging systems are electromagnetic sensors used for detecting, locating, and tracking objects of varying kinds at different distances. Radar is used for air traffic control, weather observations, speed measurements for law enforcement, space surveillance, and planetary observation. It uses electromagnetic energy reflected and refracted off targets to measure its location and speed. Our design focuses on the reflection and refraction of electromagnetic waves on objects and how we perceive the concept of electromagnetic energy and radio waves. Bergen Hog Sam Lake. Parasitic Petroleum. Petroleum. Petroleum is a product used in everyday items from ballpoint pens to diesel fuel. This design by Bergen Hog and Samuel Lank combines a sleek, futuristic essence with heaps of garbage, representing both sides of the petroleum industry and its impacts. A hard avant-garde sci-fi suit element represents the way petroleum has made our society leap forward with innovation. Accentuated shoulders display the outreach of petroleum products. This eccentric and outrageous essence is also meant to represent the elite that continuously profit from petroleum products. Mountains of refuse on the appendages offer a pessimistic look at the parasitic nature of petroleum on our planet and the footprint it leaves behind. Rachel Humphrey, Riley Johnson, Alex Owens, artificially human, automated intelligence machine learning. AI machine learning is a powerful and new technology, and as is the case with any new technology, we often push it to heights that we shouldn't out of curiosity or greed to see how far it can go. In this case, instead of focusing our efforts to benefit schooling, nursing, or getting rid of dangerous jobs, we emphasize our efforts on media coverage and conversation of this technology on intrinsically human things, deepfakes, personal tracking, AI artwork, and writing. We are verging on the questions, how much do we allow our machines to do and to take from us? Andrian Mueller, Katie Nurkin, consoles and their games, video game consoles. We are showcasing the intricacies of consoles and their games. After the video game crash of 1983 caused the video game industry to be extinct, in 1986, Nintendo released the NES, introducing it to the market as a toy instead of marketing it as a video game console. As marketing the NES as a toy instead of a console helped regrow the video game market as to what it is today. This interpretation we wanted to showcase the evolution of console controllers as well as their games and how they brought people together through their iconic worlds. From warfare to recreational and scientific use, the submarine has become a huge tool today. The history of the submarine dates back to 1620. The original model was built from greased leather and a wood structure. Today, they are built from high-strength steel. These artists wanted to incorporate the aged with the current and up-to-date look in their piece. Taking the wooden structures, greased leather, and a grungy look up top to the sleek steel down low, they wanted to explore the beauty of evolution, portraying the old with the new. Grace Brand, Michaela Shelley, an upward adventure, elevator. Imagine working on the 8th floor of a building and climbing up all those stairs to get to your office every day. With the invention of an elevator, this is no longer a problem. With this as our theme, we want you to look both travel back in time and keep in mind the modern style of transportation. When looking at this creation, you are able to see a twist of ideas with our version of a combination lift of a lift attendant and modern time elevator. Jake Peterson, Adam McGee. The camera crew, motion camera. Photography became a part of public life in the mid-19th century, especially during the Civil War, when photographers documented American battlefields for the first time. The motion picture has always been a way for people to tell stories. Movies and motion pictures have enabled people to travel the world vicariously and experience tragedy, love, and nearly every other emotion. Through our sculpture, we highlight where the long history of motion pictures began by creating a piece focusing on the inner workings of a motion camera. Jonah Beckard, Graham Langkamp. Tools to toys, telephone. We intended to describe our interpretation of a telephone by describing how phones are perceived and used in different eras, having different cultures and available technology, as a tool or a toy. From the original use of telephones as tools to the evolution of their use as a toy. Our costume represents the innovation of phone technology across different periods of time. It represents a different type of user for different versions of this technology. Michaela Bohm, Annika Miller. Ceramics. Ceramics date all the way back to the late Paleolithic period, and they played a large role in the advancement of technologies throughout time. What first started as the discovery of mixing clay with water has led to functional works of art, bricks, tiles, glass, and now to the advanced bioceramics that are used to create synthetic bones and joints. Ceramics might not be immediately come to mind when discussing innovations or inventions, but they have had a huge impact on human civilization. Elizabeth Borgert, Avery Hart, Manifest Destiny Railroad and Steam Engine. This design is based off of the straight and curved lines contained within the shape of a train car, as well as the materials that are commonly transported by the steam engine. After the invention of the train car, Americans held a common belief that it was their duty and right to conquer the West, leading to the extinction of many Native Americans of the Great Plains. This idea is reflected in this piece through the reference of John Gass' painting American Progress and John O'Sullivan's coined term, Manifest Destiny. Callie Heisenling, Kate Holst, and Ava Thomas. Look into the light bulb. In the year 1879, Thomas Edison invented the incandescent light bulb that was said to burn long enough to light an entire home for hours on end. Without the invention of light bulbs, we would not have any other electrical items such as refrigerators, radios, and chandeliers. Evidently, light bulbs paved the way for other inventors and entrepreneurs. In this sculptural piece, we explore this revolutionary invention to create a reflective form that portrays light, electricity, and creativity. This color-bursting sculpture represents the shining innovations brought forth from the creation of the light bulb. Helena Keating, Amanda Lansing, Brooke Wormer. Steel bombastic, steel. Steel is the foundation for the infrastructure that we use every day. It's in our housing, cars, tools, and an endless number of things. It protects us, gives us electricity, and makes our lives comfortable. To demonstrate steel's omnipresence, we crafted a washer-shaped skirt that doubles as a cityscape. The style of our piece is inspired by the Eugene hat and puff shoulder pads of the Industrial Revolution. The 1932 hot rod was also influential in our design, with the grill plastered on the corset and its wheels on the ankles and hat of the model. Behold, steel bombastic. Clarice Appleby, Logan Lautenschlager. Over assembly line, moving assembly line. The moving assembly line revolutionized manufacturing in the early 20th century, allowing for mass production and increased efficiency. However, the rapid pace of production and consumption has contributed to our current throwaway society, where waste is generated just as fast as it is produced. The overproduction and disposal of goods that have led to significant environmental damage, particularly with the rise of e-waste. Through innovation and creativity, we can reimagine manufacturing and fashion design to prioritize sustainability and reduce waste. Shadow over nature, forge, anvil, and power hammer. Within a world of metal and fire, there stands a beauty unseen. Hidden below a shadow that desaturates life and replaces it with a cold shell of steel, vibrant colors push their way through the cracks of humanity's armor. And although it may seem like a fruitless attempt to break free, in these conditions, life clings onto strength, perseverance, and hope. Tools of modern and ancient societies, the anvil and power hammer, are symbolic of creation. Nature breaking free from a modern environment and thriving even in dull and bleak environments was heavily used as inspiration for our design. Maddie Hill, Eve Powell, Amy Vu. Movement, seatbelts. We ideated using the functionality of seatbelts along with their discomfort. Though seatbelts are mechanisms that ensure safety, it is still constricting, occasionally suffocating, and at times ill-fitting. We use this idea of safety and constraint with social movements that have impacted us on a personal level, such as Black Lives Matter and Stop Asian Hate. We wanted to emphasize how common it is to silence people and to, above all else, keep us from making a move that goes against the grain of socially acceptable. Rupp, Henry Williamson, R equals R1, R2, RN. Calculator. Humans have wanted to make ways to automate and make math easier since they started counting on their fingers. The first counting machine, which evolved into the calculator we know today, was the abacus, invented in the 2nd century BCE in China. It wouldn't be until the 1960s that we were able to count computerized calculation. This changed the entire culture and process surrounding math. When calculators became digitized, people thought that calculators were shortcut and cheated real math. Our piece took the form of a calculator and broke it down into its basic forms. The black coat is reminiscent of digital calculator's case, hiding the knowledge and code within it. You can see the brains of the calculator hiding under the coat. Alex Armand, Noah Kowalski, lie to me, lie detector. This piece is designed with some of the common themes of Mad Max and the Apocalypse's found object style in mind. With Velcro straps, steel wire, and high contrast colors, the delinquent prisoner's jumpsuit is highlighted. The exaggerated shape and form of various sheep features, such as the headdress and the petticoat-esque frame external from the shirt, enhance the overall three-dimensional quality of the design. With the concept of suffering in silent captivity and the injustice of the unreliability of the polygraph test, we present Project Still Luge. Moth Chase, Tommy Wyatt. The Gothic Buttress, Flying Buttress. Our innovation is flying buttresses, which is a part of Gothic buildings on the outside. We also chose to add the details of window wheels. Flying buttresses were originally created to add the additional support to the outside of the buildings, while also allowing the structure to be bigger inside as well as less support was needed. We used that information to create the support that was the flying buttress on the skirt and use the wheel windows to add details in a very similar way as to how it is with Gothic architecture. Alyssa Hill's August Westlethlow, the lone diver, scuba deer. Over 100 years ago, a diver went missing during one of his ocean explorations. Almost 200 years later, a siren emerges from the ocean, wearing a modified version of his scuba gear. The grime of the ocean has worn away at the suit, creating a much more rustic and rugged look, visibly shown by the helmet and air tank constructed by a degraded scalp metal. Many men have attempted to catch the siren throughout her years of roaming the ocean, as shown by the fishnet chains and rope that covers her. Alex Saferth, Evie Uitz. New heights. Escalator. This design will take you to new heights in the world. The escalator is a staple in our lives and technology most of us take for granted. It's a type of vertical transportation in the form of a moving staircase which carries people between floors of a building. 1892, a guy named Jesse W. Reno involved a conveyor belt that was set at an incline of 25 degrees. The planks of the conveyor belt were metal with serrated edge, much like the ones today. This allowed for a smooth transition between the belt and the landings by combining serrated planks with a set of comb-like teeth at the top and bottom landings. Allison Grangard, Lucas Switzer. Navigator's aid, compass. Heliodix heliodisc is meant to resemble a sundial compass, which is more intricate and detailed version of the compass that most of us are familiar with. The added dimension of the spire gives the extra needed space to make this project more three-dimensional so it can be viewed from more angles. Additionally, there are representations of the sky and sun surrounding the sundial compass to bring the sun design to life and aid in understanding the piece. William Stock, Mike Teal. Brick Blast, Wrecking Ball. The Wrecking Ball was created in 1888, with the original creator unknown, as several companies have claimed the original creation. The true creator is still being disputed today. The Wrecking Ball has been a major industrial tool used by construction companies to tear down buildings for new ones to be erected. This piece worn by Mike Teal represents the destructive capabilities of the Wrecking Ball while also displaying aspects of modern safety regulations. Sophie just said scheme. Say cheese, the still camera. Joseph Nikiforovich invented the first version of the still camera in 1816, with the first photo being taken in 1826. Our concept is based on the evolution of the still camera. Our team included concepts such as the camera's flash and the lens's reflective aspect. We used the body paint to our advantage to demonstrate the transition between black and white to colored cameras. The color photograph dates to 1848, when the French physicist Edmond Boccaccio first created it at the Museum de Histoire Naturelle in Paris. We show this by painting the specific cameras that can capture color. Lila Daly, Miguel Hageman, Andrew Stewart. Circadian Sky Glow, LED lighting. As time progresses and technology advances, society has overtaken the night sky with the glow of busy cities. Circadian Sky Glow is an art piece that illuminates the effect that artificial lighting has on the natural cycle of day and night. The fog of light pollution obscures the stars our ancestors told stories of and followed for guidance as they traveled, but the beauty of the night remains dazzling when consciously sought out. Jade Kimbrough, Autumn Markson. Silken knives, flatware, and silverware. Our innovation is silverware and flatware. When deciding what we wanted in our design, we looked at the history of flatware and found it was originally popularized in Egypt and traveled to the Western world via the Silk Road. We paid homage to this with the ribbon-like shapes that float both down the arms and swirl around the body. We also looked at Egyptian fashion, and this is where the shape and the headpiece and the colorful beading came from. Our concept started as a warrior and quickly developed into something much bigger, a god. This forceful god of cutlery who defends with silken knives. Sydney Osterduck, Autumn Sokonaho, and Lily Benson. The Earth is just our base, spaceship. Welcome to a world where the Earth is just our base, featuring a solar system and a spaceship that is out of this world. Come and adventure with us as we travel with a futuristic UFO into the depths of space. Spaceships shape the way for humans to discover what is beyond space and search for planets outside of our home, Earth. As spaceships continue to develop and evolve, the mysteries that once lied beyond our atmosphere have become clearer. But don't become too comfortable. There are so many unknowns about what lies out of reach from Earth. Vianna Gray, Albert Osmoransky, Blake Strand, Jordan Trober. Hearing and fashion, cochlear implants. Our invention and innovation is the cochlear implant. They are surgically inserted behind the ear under the skin to help people with limited or no hearing. There is a receiver in your ear that sends electrodes into the cochlea, which helps produce sound. With our design, we want to show the beauty of having hearing impairment. We are hoping to capture the culture of the deaf community and show our appreciation to the people who have made an impact over our society. Courtney King, Kaylin Clark. A spectacle of history. Eyeglasses. Eyeglasses, that curved, shiny glass that brings clarity to the world. So sharp and delicate, it frames the world in our dress. Carefully crafted crystal shards decorate and bring emphasis to the large, abstract ice glasses on the front of the skirt. Gaining more structure and popularity in the 18th century, the hoop skirt and bodice honors the past. The ingenuity of design and variety of materials directs to a positive and inventive future for eyewear. Lily Staber, Riley Strobush, sci-fi girl of the 90s, VHS tapes. VHS tapes thrived in the past due to their easy accessibility. The VHS was made in 1976 by JVC, defining a decade with the variety of film that was shown to the world. Not only that, but VHS tapes had a remarkable impact on the sci-fi genre, especially in the 90s. Movies such as Mars Attack, Independence Day, Total Recall, and so many more became a part of home entertainment due to VHS. Olivia Ostrom, Sam Murphy. Sweet Treat, Pez. Watch out! If you have a sweet tooth, this look is for you. Sam Murphy and Olivia Ostrom are going to take you on a trip down memory lane with the timeless treat that all generations adore. The flavors that you know and love are presented using bright neon vinyl. However, it doesn't stop there. We also included the original Pez wrappers and the candies. So, we are dispensing out a sweet treat. Look to you. Lillian Ketterhagen, Claire Monaco, Lady Penelope, ballpoint pen. Our project focuses on 1880s American women's fashion, emphasizing floral elements, tying the theme of the ballpoint pen with the style period by incorporating a floral ballpoint pen. Our character is Lady Penelope, a florist who loves to write poetry. And last but certainly not least, Ryan Heer, Luke Leganagan, Isaiah Lumens, Sneaky Cipher, Telegraph. The electric telegraph, invented by Samuel F. B. Morse in 1837, was a machine that transmitted electromagnetic dots and dashes to a receiver, which was used as a form of communication. It became the foundation of modern communication technology and had several additional innovations throughout its lifetime, eventually being used internationally. Its uses in communicating in secret, as well as the invention of Morse code, which coincided with it, inspired a design of the piece. Between the clothing inspired by those worn at the time, to the use of hidden information throughout the piece's smaller details. As I said, that was our last, but they are not the least, of course, and the show is not over yet. You guys will get to see a video of behind the scenes, as well as another walkthrough. This is to give our wonderful judges some time to deliberate and decide who is going to be the recipient of our wonderful prizes this evening. So, let's do our walkthrough.
Oh, it was all about you. Now I feel so far removed. You are the one thing in my way. 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 You are the one thing in my way.
seeing them again, and you also enjoyed seeing the other bodies behind the process. There were very few groups of one, and I couldn't imagine myself trying to put a piece as extravagant as these are together by myself, so it's very important that they have groups. Next up, we have a video with some behind the scenes, just to show you what it was like in the classroom as they were working on these projects, so go ahead.
Joel, what are you making? How is that coming? Good? Bad? Indifferent? How's the camera coming? Right here, Noah. Thumbs up.
For the moment, you all, I'm sure, have been waiting for. I'm sure a lot of you came to see friends or family or whatever, but let's be real. We're here to see who wins. Everybody wins in our hearts, though. So, first off, the winner of the Accessories and Styling Award goes to The Fast Knight. Congratulations, you guys. All right, moving on to our next award. Innovative use of materials goes to the Protector. Congratulations. Moving on to our next award, we have Avant-Garde Fashion, which goes to ceramics. And moving on to our fourth and final of our kind of fun, funky awards, we have Artistry and Craft, which goes to Movement. Congratulations. And now that we've covered our kind of fun and funky awards, it is time to move on to our first, second, and third place, as well as our $1,000 scholarship award winner. So, in third place, we have Manifest Destiny. Go down to the interstate. Congratulations. All right, on to second place, we have the Gaslighter. Wow. Ooh, ooh, ooh. You're okay. All right, moving on to judges' choice first place. Can I get a drum roll, please? Priority Mail. Congratulations. All right. And it feels like the last, but it's not the last. We have a scholarship to award. So the scholarship winner of the 2023 Fashion Without Fabric Scholarship is, drumroll, Transmutator. Congratulations. Oh my gosh, what a night. It was a really, really fun time. Before we close out, I really want to say some thank yous. Thank you to all of the volunteers that helped us run the show. You guys did really, really good work. I also want to recognize the faculty that teach 3D design. Our event advisors that are critical to the success of an event like this. And Kathy Weiss. Kathy Weissman, she is very important to our job. Also, the event technology crew for helping set up, run, and tear down the show. Oh my goodness. You guys wouldn't be able to see these works without them. So you don't need me, you need them. So, and our two student coordinators who made this happen, Ellie Johnson and Melody Zmish. And thank you all that are still in the house. I see some of you snuck out. But thank you for being supportive and supporting your students and friends and family and coming and hanging out at Destination Weekend. Travel safely. Thank you again for coming. Please exit carefully. But you don't seem to mind. Your heart seems indifferent. I'm trying to break the ice. I'm waiting an hour to bring the heat back to life. You used to ignite me. Without the sun, I don't know where you are. I don't know how we get through the dark without the sun. Without the sun.
the sun. I don't know where you are, I don't know how we get through the dark without the sun. All the love's running out, I don't wanna let go of your heart without the sun.
Realize so vacant in my-